than mine. Hi, how are you? I'm pretty good. Thank you so much for asking. Happy Halloween. Thank you. What can I do for you today? Obviously, you want a face painting, but what kind of face painting would you like? Well, that sounds nice, but I think I can think of something way better for you. What am I supposed to be? Come on, I'll give you one guess. You can't tell from my ears. No. You want to try one more time? No, I'm queen of the snow bunnies. Duh, can't you see my crown? Look, it's really not a hard costume. It's just something simple. I really love my ears. But yeah, I think I can think of something way better than a dumb old cat. Yeah, okay. Well, look, by letting me do whatever I want to do on your face, I'll give you one piece of candy. How about that? There you go. Okay, so let me go ahead. I'm going to have to wash your face first, and then I'll go ahead and get started, because I don't like painting on, like, dirty faces, because paint doesn't stick well and, you know, all of that extra stuff. So if you don't mind, I'm going to have to get really up close and personal. So, of course, I'm going to be touching your face, so I have my hand sanitizer right here, okay? And I'm just going to put some into my hand. Make sure my hands are all clean, okay? Next, I have these face cleansing pads, and they're just going to... I get a few idea for what I want to paint on your face, okay? So, your forehead actually is like really flat. It's not bumpy, which is really good. So, that's gonna be good for me to paint some kind of, like, I don't know, crown. Because you see, that's the theme. We're gonna be the queen and king of everything, whatever you identify as, okay? To make you the ruler of, because you have this nose and it just is so strong. Like, you have really strong features. Like, you know, I have a pretty hefty nose, so it looks cute as a little bunny, but yours is really strong and it looks like you assert dominance. So let's make you ruler of the cats. How about that? Not too boring. How about ruler of the pumpkin patch? Yeah, I can make you a crown or a tiara and then paint you two big pumpkins because you got some really cute cheeks. cute. Okay, so first things first, I have my brushes here, but I need some water in them, so I also have a cup of water right here. I'm just gonna pour it. It's good. And just let the brushes sit in there for a while so that they're nice and clean. When it's time for me to use them, yeah. And I'll just go ahead and get all of the colors together that I'm going to use. So I keep all of my paints in here. And when you open it up, inside is just all the paint. Okay. And I also have just a secondary case of paint. See, just more paint in here. And I'm definitely going to need this light green for your pumpkin. Right here. Might need some burnt sienna. It's kind of like brown. And I think that's all I will need from this. Okay. And this is just what I'm going to put the paint on. And out of here, let's see what colors I'm going to need. The orange for your pumpkin, gold for your crown. You can add little diamonds to your crown, how about that? You can add some sky blue. And we also have vermilion. Vermilion, okay? And that's just a really, really bright orange. So are you ready to get started? Okay. So I'm going to put my hair up so that it's not in the way. So I'm going to need for you to be completely still, okay? Don't move your face at all. I have a steady hand, but I'm going to need for your face to remain steady as well so that I can make all your lines and squiggles and your little pumpkins as perfect as possible, okay? So let's start with your crown. How about that? So we agreed on a gold crown with sky blue diamonds, correct? Okay, so let me go ahead and just put the paint down on the palette. Just put some right there. And we're gonna start with the base of the crown first. We can't put jewels on a nothing. We have to have the crown first. So I have this. I'm just going to dry it off with this. And start. So we got our gold. I'm going to go straight across. Like a nice straight line. actually gonna probably need a bigger brush to fill it in, but that's okay. Filling it in, making sure that I don't miss anything. Okay. So I'm gonna let that dry for a little bit, but I'm gonna have to blow it. Little placements in your crown. Okay. Let me just add one more layer of that, okay? So your crown is complete, which is really good. I'm glad. It actually came out really perfect. Just be still, don't move, okay? Okay. Now the only thing I have left to do is the pumpkins, which is really good because I'm starting to get a little line, but you can't rush perfection, can you? So I'll actually let you pick which orange you want. You can either have the regular orange or you can have the vermilion. Which one? Okay. That's no problem. I can do that. Let me just put it right here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to do both at the same time so that they're like twins and not sisters, so they're being made at the same time and not one made one time and one made one time. So I'm gonna show you what I mean. I have to get a new brush. Try it off. Okay. So now get it onto your brush, right? And then you start circles on one side. I'm gonna have to move this out the way so I can get your angles really good, because I'd rather move than you move your face. And on the second side, I'm sorry, I'm left-handed. Well, you know what? It's just circles. I can do it. Perfect. So, you got your circles. Now, while your circles are drying, I'm going to make your stem. Okay? And the stem part is actually pretty simple. People be thinking it's, you know, hard because it's not a straight line, but it's actually pretty simple. So, I'm actually going to show you how I do it with this. So, I take some and I put it on here. I take a brush. Really thin brush. This brush, this is the thinnest brush that I have. Of course, brush, you want to dry the brush, take some off of your palette, right? And the thing is, as you're applying pressure, you're gonna lift it just a little bit like this, see? But you're gonna move it in a straight line. So you're gonna feel how I'm doing it on your face, but yeah, just be still, okay? Yeah, it's cold, isn't it? I don't know why, on my cheeks it seems like it's more sensitive to temperature than our forehead, which is really crazy because people check their temperature using their forehead. There. Really nice, precise stems. Look at the stems, you know they don't have to be straight. Like, they're stems, so they're imperfect, right? Now, I'm going to add the leaves, and then I'm going to draw faces on the pumpkins, okay? So, for the leaves, I have this green, it's light green. Mm-hmm. It's not even open yet, sorry. So you just open it up, place it, show you the same thing how I'm gonna do the leaf. You place some on here. Going to take another thin brush, and usually I'll clean the brush that I had, but don't have time. I'd rather use one that I was already clean. You take some off of your palette, and then with this, I'm just gonna go like that from the stem, literally just like that, and just add a stem like that. And that's going to be one of the leaves from your pumpkin, okay? But you only need one leaf per pumpkin, unless you want me to add two. No, okay, that's fine. Just this one, I'm filling it in. Okay, and now this one. Okay. So by now the orange part should be dry. So literally the only thing that I have left is to draw the face. I have black right here, but of course we can make the face any color you want. So this is what's really going to tie it together, what color the face is, okay? So we can make it a traditional black, but if you want to do pink, blue, gray, gold, whatever color you want to do, we can do it. I can actually give you my case, and you can go through here and figure out which one it is you want. How about that? How about that? Okay, good. So I'm going to leave you with my case, and I'm going to try to clean up some of this stuff. When I get done cleaning my brushes, then you should have it picked out. How about, yeah, how's that sound? Okay, here you go. Can I see what you picked? Oh, wow, okay, I really like that color. Okay, so that'll be really good. I'll go ahead and just take that from you. Thank you. So, please. Go ahead and start painting the face. Now, what kind of facial expression you want? Happy, sad, surprised, scared? Okay. I can definitely do that. Okay. Let me do the eye. Nose and the mouth. So the mouth is really the most trickiest part to me because You want it to be missing some teeth, and you want it to make it look like it's missing teeth and not lip, you know? But I got it. I got it really good. So now I have to try to do this side the same color. So let me do the eye. Alright, so hang on, I actually got a little bit, okay, good, now you look better, I just had to clean that little spot up, so, let me give you a mirror. So this is what it looks like. You like it? You look on this side and this side. I'm so glad you like it. Yeah, I really took my time with it because now we have a line of people, but it's no problem. I work pretty fast. Yes, I really like every face painting experience with me to be, you know, unique. Like, I don't want it to be just, you know, something rushed, you know? I'm glad you feel the same way. Well, hopefully I see you around, yeah? Alright, thanks. You were really my favorite customer by far today. Everything went super smooth. Alright, well, I'll see you later, yeah?